Hello everyone, in this lesson I'll be talking about tracheal collapse in dogs. So tracheal collapse is a very common disease in clinical practice. It is a chronic, progressive and irreversible disease of the trachea and often also lower airways known as bronchi collapse. The trachea is this flexible tube similar to a vacuum cleaner tube and there's C-shaped small rings of cartilage that help keep the airway open. And so why does this collapse happen? Well, this disease is known for having primary and secondary factors. Firstly, it is required that the dog has a pre-existing cartilage abnormality that results in cartilage weakness. And secondly, there must be something that triggers the appearance of the clinical signs. This something may be obesity, cardiomegaly, inhalation of irritant substances or allergens, periodontal disease, respiratory infections, and also because of a recent intubation regarding one other procedure. So in these dogs, the C-shaped cartilage becomes weak and appears as a dorsoventral flattening of the tracheal rings that causes an obstruction of the airway. This collapse can be in the cervical area, the thoracic area, or even both, usually with the cervico-thoracic junction being the most pronounced area of collapse. So what happens is that with the respiratory cycle, during inspiration, expansion of the thorax creates a negative pressure within the thoracic cavity, allowing inflow of air. Thus, a weakness in the cervical airway is likely to show during inspiration. During expiration, compression of the thorax creates a positive pressure within the thoracic cavity, allowing outflow of air, and for that reason, a weakness in an intrathoracic airway is likely to show during expiration. So this is a disease that is commonly seen in middle-aged to older toy, miniature, and small dogs, especially in Yorkshire Terriers, Maltese, Chihuahuas, Pugs, Poodles, and Pomeranians. The most characteristic clinical sign in dogs is with this disease is what is called goose-honk cough, very much like in this video. Usually, this cough is triggered by exercise, excitement, pulling on a leash, or even drinking water. These dogs are also intolerant to exercise and present with dyspnea. If these signs present for a long period of time, we may see cyanosis or even a dog that collapses because of airway obstruction. When we are presented with a small dog with history of chronic cough, we should perform a complete physical exam that could direct us towards one or other diagnosis. During the physical examination, if we apply a very light pressure on the trachea and the dog starts coughing or with difficult breathing, this may raise suspicion of tracheal collapse. Then we should do complete blood work to look at overall health of the dog. And also very important is to perform chest x-rays to confirm and assess the severity of the tracheal collapse and also to identify possible concomitant disease. Other causes of coughing as heart failure must be ruled out, and sometimes heart disease and collapsed trachea are present at the same time. We must also be aware that tracheal collapse is not always visible on regular x-rays, and in some dogs, fluoroscopy, that is a dynamic x-ray, an endoscopy or even a CT may be indicated for further investigations. The immediate treatment in a dog with tracheal collapse lays on oxygen, also sedatives and antitussive agents as butorphanol or aspromazine to break the coughing cycle, since coughing will irritate the airway and lead to more coughing. Corticosteroids also to decrease inflammation of the airways, Other measures indicated are weight reduction in the obese animals. This is absolutely essential since it is a trigger for the tracheal collapse. Sometimes it is even curative of the clinical signs with no need of further treatment. Replacements of neck collars with harnesses, since pulling the leash can also trigger the cough. If the dog has smoking odors or is in a house with dust, remove the dog from all those respiratory irritants. Detect and treat concomitant diseases, as we have seen sometimes these dogs that have also cardiac disease, and in those cases it is important to detect and treat those conditions. Long-term treatment for these cases are low doses of corticosteroids orally or by inhalation, oral antitussive agents to control the cough as hydrocodone or butorphanol. Bronchodilators can be useful if the collapse is occurring in the lower trachea to reduce bronchospasm. Dogs that fail the medical management are candidates for placement of extraluminal tracheal rings in a cervical tracheal collapse or intraluminal stents in an intrathoracic tracheal collapse. In both situations, it is advised to do a pre-surgical CT to measure the tracheal size and also to do a bronchoscopy to assess the presence of bronchomalacia and or lower airway disease, as these situations greatly impact the prognosis. So it is important to note that collapsing trachea is a progressive disease, as the tracheal cartilage can continue to deteriorate over time despite treatment. The American College of Veterinary Surgeons reports that about 70% of dogs that are treated with medical management alone will show some improvement, and about 75% of dogs improve after surgical placement of rings. Even pets that have surgery for the condition often need medication for life, and overall the prognosis will depend on how well the dog responds to therapy. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any question, please leave a comment below.